मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द बायोलॉजी क्लास 11th. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू हैव आवर फर्स्ट सेशन इन द बायोलॉजी. व्हाट इज बायोलॉजी? बायोलॉजी मींस द स्टडी ऑफ लिविंग ऑर्गेनिजम्स, इन विच वी स्टडी अबाउट द माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म, अबाउट द प्लांट्स, अबाउट द एनिमल्स. Biology is also being known as a life sciences because we are studying the functioning, we are studying the structure, we are studying the internal structure of all the living organism in the subject biology. So welcome to the biology class 11th. So today we are going to start with our first session, and the syllabus of the biology is have in your class 11th. Class 11th biology is consist of 5 units. The name of your first unit is diversity in living world, in which we will discuss about the various kingdoms like monera, protista, fungi, plantae and animal in detail, and this unit carries only 7 marks. The second unit is structural organization in plants and animal, in which we are discuss the morphology, means the external study of the plants and animal, anatomy, that is the internal structure of plants and animal with the tissues in plants and animal, and the weightage of that unit is 12 marks. The third unit is cell structure and function, in which we discuss about the structure of the cell, prokaryotic cell, eukaryotic cell, biomolecule, that will be a new chapter for you, and cell division, that is your mitosis and meiosis, and that carries 15 marks. The fourth unit is plant physiology. Physiology means the functioning of plants, in which we discuss about the various metabolic activities of the plants like transportation, nutrition, respiration, photosynthesis, growth and the reproduction. The last unit of your NCERT book is human physiology, in which we discuss about the various metabolic activities, the functioning of our body, starting from digestion, respiration, circulation, excretion, locomotion, neural coordination, endocrine system, and that carries 18 marks. So total theory paper of biology will be of 70 marks, practical is of 30 marks, total that is of 100 marks, but you have to clear both in practical as well as in theory separately. So best of luck for your class 11th. Welcome to the class 11th, and let's start with our unit 3, that is cell structure and function. This is very simple, fundamental and the basic unit. You must have studied that unit in your 9th class, and that's why we are starting with this unit, as we are having a motto to start from easy to difficult. So let's start with our 3rd unit, cell structure function. And the chapter of that particular unit is cell, the unit of life. What is cell? As we know, all the living organisms, they are made up of cell. Cell is considered as a basic unit of life. Therefore, the cell is defined as the structural and the functional unit of life. Anything less than a complete structure of cell does not ensure the independent living. Means if the living, if any structure is not made up of cell, means that is not a complete structure. Therefore, the cell is fundamental, structural and the functional unit of living organism. So what is cell? How you will define the cell? The cell is defined as the structural and the functional unit of life, and each living organism is made up of cell because cell is the basic unit of life. Types of organism. Based on number of cells, they are of 2 types. Number 1 is unicellular organism, and number 2 is multicellular organism. So first we will discuss what are unicellular organism. Unicellular organism, an organism made up of only one cell. Uni means one cell. An organism made up of only one cell is called unicellular organism, and examples is amoeba, paramecium, euglena and plasmodium. You can see in the images of the amoeba, which is a very irregular shape and it is made up of one cell only. Paramecium, that is considered to be as a sleeper like structure, means jaise aapke pair ka hai, that is called as a sleeper like structure but made up of only a single cell. That is euglena, that is again made up of only single cell. So they are made up of only one cell. So amoeba, paramecium, euglena, they are being known as the unicellular organism. So what is unicellular organism, which are made up of only one cell, are called as a unicellular organism. Multicellular organism, an organism which is made up of more than one cell, is called multicellular organism. So how you will distinguish between the unicellular and multicellular organism? Unicellular organism made up of only one cell. Multicellular organisms are made up of more than one cell. Example of unicellular is amoeba, paramecium, and the example of multicellular is human, tree, plant, animal. They all comes under the category of multicellular organisms. So in this picture you can see the number of the multicellular organism are there. They are the animals which are made up of more than one cell, so they come under the category of multicellular organism. The next is advantages of unicellular. So what is the advantages of unicellular? Unicellular, one cell, that is independent existence. So they can be independent, they can do each and every metabolic activities by itself. Number two is performing all the essential function of life. As we have seen in the picture of amoeba, that made up of one cell, that is having a nuclei, they are having a mitochondria, cytoplasm. So all the functions of the body, that is your respiration, digestion, that is performed by the single cell. So performing all the essential function of the life, independent existence, and they can easily adapt to the environment because they are of a small size. Sometimes they cannot be even seen by the naked eyes. They are basically seen by the microscopes. So they can be easily adapt to the surrounding, to the environment. So these are the advantage of being a unicellular. So number one is independent existence, performing all the essential function of life, and they can easily adapt to the environment. Disadvantage of unicellular, because that is of a very small size, so when that unicellular organism will attain the size, means when they will grow and they will divide into two daughter cells, so they are having a shorter lifespan and cannot grow very large, and that's why their survival is lesser. So function, we can say the function, we can say the advantage of unicellular, that is independent existence, performing all the essential functioning of the life, and they can adapt to the environment. But on the another side, because they cannot grow very large, they cannot mature, because as soon as they mature, they will divide, so they have a shorter lifespan. Now you can see in this image the level of organization, because we said that multicellular organism is made up of more than one cell. So how that particular multicellular organism are going to be formed? So cell, if there is only one cell, means the unicellular. When the cell, they become in the group, so group of cell is known as tissues, and group of tissue, that known as your organ. And group of organ, they will form the organ system. As you can see, there is one organ, that is your stomach, and stomach, liver, intestine, that forms the organ system, that is known as the digestive system. And similarly, such type of number of the organ systems like digestive system, circulatory system, respiratory system, muscular system, they all form one organism. So we are having a five level of organizations. Number one is cell, which is known as a basic unit of life, group of cell that forms a tissue, and group of tissue, they form the organ. Organ form the organ systems, and then it will form the organism that is known as your multicellular organism, because that is made up of more than one cell. Advantages of multicellular. Cells are organized into tissues, and group of tissues performing a similar functions form the organs, and the group of organs form the organ system, each of which perform a particular function in a coordinating way for the benefit of multicellular organism. Means multicellular organism consists of more than one cell. That more than one cell means it is a group of cell tissues performing a particular function. Group of tissues forms the organ, and group of organs form the organ system, which are performing a particular function. For example, digestive system, respiratory system, circulatory system, they are performing the very particular function. For example, digestive system will help in digestion. Respiratory system will help in respiration. Circulatory system helps in transportation of blood. And nervous system are controlling all the systems. So the work is being distributed among all the organs. That's why the efficiency of multicellular organism has increased. That particular distribution of work is known as division of labor, which is possible only in the multicellular organism, because they are made up of more than one cells. They are made up of different type of the organ system, and each organ system is performing its own function in the coordinating way for the benefit of the multicellular organism, and that distribution of work is known as division of labor. And because of that, because of the division of labor, the efficiency of multicellular organism is more, and due to which the lifespan increases. So this is our advantage of multicellular organism. This is how the multicellular organism are better than the unicellular organism, why they are having a better survival rate than that of the unicellular organism, only because of the division of labor. They can adapt themselves, they can have a better survival as compared to the unicellular organism. So this is all the difference between the unicellular multicellular organism. This is all about today's lecture. Next lecture will be on the cell theory and historical aspect of the cell. Till then, stay home, stay safe, stay healthy. Goodbye. Thank you.